actually have transitioning out of shelters.
Already this week, 41 buses have rolled into Chicago. That means there are now 11,000 migrants living in shelters. 4,000 are still sleeping on police station floors and staying at the airports. There have been calls by city officials to close the Inn of Chicago shelter site after reports of criminal behavior, including drug sales and prostitution. Passione Zayas says it's not shutting down.
We are in a lease. You know, that's the other thing.
This chart shows the number of migrant children now enrolled within the Chicago public schools. 30% of migrants here in Chicago are children. The migrant crisis is straining resources. The state is footing the bill for what they call temporary housing. The state is paying on the high end $9,000 in rental assistance over a six-month period of time. With that comes help moving in and a starter kit to furnish the apartment.
Can you guys believe that with all of our homeless vets and our homeless Americans that we are giving these people paying 6 months for their apartment that are here illegally? And we're paying them, our tax money is paying them. When we have all of our people on the street, Americans, veterans even, on the streets, mentally fucked up and on a bunch of drugs, and they're sleeping in tents and old, like, cardboard fucking cardboard condos, you know, cardboard box, and these motherfuckers are getting $9,000 for rent, plus food, plus all this other stuff, and we have so many homeless people. We can't do this. This is absolutely fucking ridiculous. Anyway, I'll continue.
That rent lasts for 6 months, and ideally people would have started their legal process, secured legal work authorization, and then be able to sustain that apartment.
The city put $4 million towards helping migrants get temporary housing. Right now, there are just a handful of case managers to handle the load to get migrants in temporary rentals.
They have roughly, like, I want to say in the ballpark of 30 to 40. But we obviously, you know, need to get more. And so that's when we approached the state again for an additional $5 million.
We did reach out to see how many asylum seekers are currently taking advantage of the rental assistance. We haven't heard back from the city on that. Tia Ewing, Fox 32, Chicago.
Jesus, I can't even believe this. No, here, let's watch this one.
It was a shock. We cannot financially afford it. The city of Joliet nor the township can afford this type of expense for a community.
As the state turns to communities beyond Chicago to house an influx of migrants, controversy is brewing in one southwest suburb.
Joliet Township has been awarded a multi-million dollar grant to support migrants, but not everyone is co-signing the plan.
Casey Cronus is in Joliet with the latest.
Community members say there was little to no transparency when it came to the township supervisor applying for those funds. Now some are calling for officials to withdraw the application.
A lot of us just got blindsided.
The state recently announced Joliet would be receiving...
We need to take care of our people first.
$8.6 million for shelter, housing, and health care. Not for its residents, but for migrants.
You still don't have any places for us to go, so how would they have a place to go?
Just days ago, community members Trista Brown and John Sheridan learned their city could soon become a sanctuary.
What's going to happen when you run out of the money? There's no funding sources left. You'll dry up the community resources of this small town.
The grant application was submitted by Joliet Township Supervisor Angel Contreras. According to the proposal, the township actually asked for more than $12 million to open and operate three welcome centers and one clinic that would serve roughly 1,900 migrants. One of the buildings slated for use is the Hartman Rec Center, another the Peter Claver Center, which used to be a space for youth programming.
And it saved a lot of lives here, the youth in Joliet.
Sheridan says it was purchased by the township in June with the understanding that outreach would continue, but that may no longer be the case.
They were misled and the sale is done.
Sheridan and Brown are calling for transparency.
This is in Chicago.
during a meeting Tuesday evening that's expected to draw such a large crowd, it's been moved to the auditorium at Bicentennial Park.
And we have a good feeling it's going to be totally packed.
Just to be informed and let the community come out to express what they feel.
The Joliet mayor reportedly stated he had no knowledge the grant application was filed. Meanwhile, we reached out multiple times to Supervisor Contreras for his side of the story, but have not yet heard back. Reporting in Joliet, Casey Cronus, Fox 32, Chicago.
Yeah, I'm homeless, you guys, and I don't, and they're putting these people up for 6 months with food and everything? Well, I need to be put up for 6 months. I mean, what the fuck? All these people, my brothers and sisters and my fellow Americans, need this. If we can't do this for our own people, we sure as fuck can't do it for illegal immigrants, criminals, okay? All military-aged males, I don't know why that is, but I can let my mind wander, and it doesn't have to wander too far to wander. And so, and also, when they come, they cause problems. They're usually, the reason that they're leaving their home country is because they're in jails and stuff there. So they're emptying out their fucking insane asylums and their prisons and sending them here to destabilize America and to take over America from the inside. They're all fucking male-aged, military-aged males, you know? So let's look at this. Migrant students attacked after school in Rogers Park. Good.
This is Chicago's very own WGN Evening News at 5.
New at 5, several migrant families are speaking up after they say their children were attacked in what they're calling an act of hate.
WGN's Christine Flores spoke with some of those families who plan to press charges. And we want to warn you, some of the video in this report is disturbing.
Good evening. The families we spoke with are from Venezuela, and they arrived here a few months ago. They say yesterday their kids were attacked after school by a group made up of minors and some adults. Now, they admit transitioning into life here in the city has been tough, but they never imagined what had led to this. The video shows a chaotic scene with people fighting near Sullivan High School in Rogers Park Wednesday afternoon. The student being attacked in this clip is 15-year-old Azrubal, Mirna Mendez's son. She says he was hit twice with a bat and kicked several times, leaving him bruised with broken ribs and a black eye.
They can't even speak our fucking language.
Azrubal says he's always looked at differently for being new and learning the language, but he never imagined it would have led to this. Anthony is another student who was attacked.
They don't provide even a translation? What the fuck, man? The guy doesn't even is speaking Venezuelan, whatever the fuck they speak there. Why is he here? And that's why these kids can see it. And other people can't. Get the fuck on, man. Go home. We can't afford you. The reason that students attacked him is they're upset because why is he getting all this stuff when their kids are watching their parents fucking being homeless and broke? With this inflation, I went and bought like two sandwiches and a thing of apple juice at the store, and it was $50, man. That's fucking Bidenomics for you.
Yesterday's incident, he says he's never experienced anything like this before, calling it shocking. He says he too
went to the hospital. Welcome to the USA, motherfucker. That's what we do here. We will fuck you up. You're not welcome here, people. Until you're welcome once we get ourselves
kicked to the ground and hit with a bat. He says he simply wants the bullying to end. In a letter sent to family, Sullivan High School principal Jeff Cook says safety is his top priority. He says Physical altercations involving members of our school community have taken place off school grounds and after dismissal. Our team has been working diligently to de-escalate these altercations, and we have also reached out to the CPS Office of Safety and Security for additional support.
Todos los padres deberíamos hablar con nuestros hijos. Yo a él le digo que evitemos problemas, que...
Mirna Mendez is sending a plea to families to talk to their children, adding that her son is walking away with bruises, but that it could have been much worse. The families we spoke with say they plan on pressing charges on those who have been identified and are at least 18 years.
How? They're here illegally. How are they, can they press charges for kids that are here, that are born here in America? They're Americans. They see these fucking migrants that can't even, they aren't even bothered to speak our language, and they come in and they see that these kids, these migrants are here illegally. They're not, they don't, can't even speak our language. They fucking are getting way more money than their own parents. This is what the kids see. And why, you know? And they're taking it into their hands, and I don't blame them.
Years old. They add that they are working with the school on a safety plan.
Now they're gonna be able to sue the American parents? What the fuck? They're here illegally. How can they do that? I mean, don't get me wrong, okay? But, you know, and I would love to help migrants out, legal migrants. And but we have too many homeless people, too many mental problems with our own citizens right now. We can't handle any more. We can't even handle our own people. So, you know, go home. They're here illegally. They need to go back, try and come in the legal way, you know. That's all I can say. Fuck, Venezuela's beautiful, man. Like, I just don't. If a country's saying, come on over here, we'll pay your rent for 6 months, we'll give you all this food and clothing, brand new shit. What is going on? They want us to be pissed off or what?
Reporting in Rogers Park, Christine Flores, WGN News.
Fuck that, man. And they've got us like, choose on the Palestinian. I'm doing a video about how you, whatever. I'm gonna fucking upload this shit. Okay, I love you guys. Sorry to be all pissed off, but it's ridiculous. I'm homeless right now myself. I don't have a place to go. I would love to get 6 months worth of rent, you know? And I've paid into this fucking country for 50 years almost. You know? And so fuck this, man. Anyway, unfortunately, I guess that's just the way it fucking is right now. I'm gonna go ahead and stop this and then load it